For this video, I asked chess.com's puzzle team to give me a list of the hardest chess puzzles on chess.com. They gave me about 20 puzzles, all rated 3,953 or 3,952, and I went through them. Admittedly, there are a number that have very computer-like inhuman solutions, but I found some that have really nice human elements, and I want to show one here. Now, this is not the hardest chess puzzle. It is rated 3,952, so mathematically, it is one elo point less than the hardest chess puzzle that I'm about to show, but this is a really nice one that has some subtle tricks that have tripped up a lot of people. I encourage you to pause your video and try to solve it right now. Well, as strong puzzle solvers, you know that you should look at forcing moves. And here, white has a number of tempting forcing moves, and obviously white needs to try to pursue a forcing path because black is threatening checkmate right here, and black is up a ton of pawns, 5 pawns to be precise, so white must succeed with the attack. Now, some of the most tempting checks, like queen g4 check, only lead to a perpetual, which might be the solution. I mean, there are puzzles that have a solution to save a draw in a difficult position, but here we are looking for a win. I think most natural for a human is the queen f5 check, and I think this has tripped up the most people. After queen f5 check, you can't block with g5 because of queen captures h7 and checkmate. So the king should pull back to h6, and here it looks like rook takes f6 check is a really simple forced mate. In fact, why is this puzzle rated so highly? It's probably just being tested, and it's not one of the most difficult problems on the site. But here, you don't have to capture the rook, which is an easy mistake in calculation to assume that your opponent has to capture when you sacrifice. After the capture, yes, this is checkmate, and a very, very nice checkmate. But after rook takes on f6 with check, black can play pawn to g6. And here, white has no good check. Amazingly, as unsafe as black's king seems to be, in this position, white doesn't even have a perpetual check, and black wins. So, backing up, we must reject the very, very tempting queen f5 check that many, many players have played, and instead we must find queen f7 check. And also, after queen f7 check, here there are some details. First, simply, if you move the king to g5, you're getting mated with queen captures here, and then queen back to g4. You have a nice mate with king on f5 and queen on g4 checkmate. And after queen f7 check, you can't block with pawn to g6 because, again, queen captures on h7, king over to g5, you get a little dance, but you get the same mating pattern. Still very pretty, not too difficult. But after queen f7 check, if the king steps back to h6, again, the most tempting move is rook captures on f6 with check. And again, if the rook is captured, you just have the same mate that we've already seen, but the rook will not be captured. Black plays pawn to g6, and at least this time we have a check. We have queen f8 check, but there is no more than a perpetual check available after check and king to g5. A horse, my kingdom for a check on the dark squares. So, backing up, we must not try to sacrifice the rook, as tempting as that is, and instead we have to play a quiet move. Quiet moves, of course, trip up all manner of puzzle solvers. Here, the quiet move is king to g4, a really beautiful point. It seems like white should have no time for this quiet move, but there's actually no check against the king on g4. The rook is getting in the black queen's way. There's no queen e2 check. You don't even have f5 check because there's a pin along the sixth rank. So the king is totally safe sitting here on g4. And now white is threatening queen captures or queen to h5 and checkmate. And there's actually just no way to stop this. For example, pawn to g6, and you just have queen f8, checkmate and one. So the best try is rook to h2, covering the h5 square. But now, finally, after much preparation, we can play rook captures on f6 with check. Here, pawn to g6 does not save the day. So pawn takes, queen takes, and a beautiful checkmate with the white king perfectly assisting the queen. It is a beautiful royal marriage. That was actually checkmate in 4. So it's crazy that a checkmate in 4 would be one of the hardest chess problems on sight. But I think you can see why, because there are so many tempting false paths to choose from. And some of the right moves, queen f7 check and king g4, are very unintuitive when you have tempting alternatives. This next problem, one of the 3,953 rated problems on site, is just a total mind bender. Now, I don't think that it's possible to solve the whole puzzle from start to finish because there are a bunch of tricky responses from Black. You basically have to solve it one move at a time, and I encourage you to pause your video as you go to try to find the next move in the position. Now, here it is white to play, and Black has just captured on e5. Black is also up a rook. As you can see, the knight has picked up the rook on h1. So white must play directly, and the first move isn't too difficult. Knight to d6 check, invading, attacking the black king, and also uncovering an attack against the knight on e5. After king e7, though, we do have our first choice, and you should reject the capture with the queen, which might look tempting at first if you haven't counted the material, because after queen takes, knight takes, yes, if black captures this knight, you do have a fork, but you're already down so much material that doesn't matter. And after knight captures on f7 with check, the king can counterattack the bishop, so everything just falls apart. So through the process of elimination, we need to pick up the knight on e5, and queen captures isn't doing it, knight takes e5 it is. Now, this is a position where one could spend a lot of time thinking about what black should do, but really black needs to capture the knight on d6. White here is threatening to just play knight takes f7. This knight is trapped over here. White is getting ready to potentially just castle and defend the knight on d6 with the rook on d1. And after all of these kinds of ideas, white will have a dominating position. Look at these two knights on d6 and e5. They are crushing it. Therefore, to basically avoid getting just squished, black does need to try and capture the knight on d6. Again, and this is going to be a huge theme of this puzzle, we should not be greedy. Capturing this pawn on f7 check just wrecks our attack. We lose all of our momentum, and black is able to uncoil and develop. So here we play b4, attacking the queen. Now, the queen cannot capture on e5 because after queen captures on e5, white can either play rook d1 or, in my opinion, much prettier, can castle with check. Black is going to have to surrender the queen and will lose the game. So after pawn b4 attacking the queen needs to pull back and has to also stop queen to c5 with checkmate. So queen c7. And here, again, we could try to cash in by going in here with knight takes f7, but we lose all of our momentum and we are down a full rook. So this is the wrong path. We need to play queen f4 with huge threats. Knight takes f7 with check, knight g6 check. Basically, all of the knight checks are deadly because of this lineup right here. White is also thinking just about castling with check and then capturing on f7 here, which will likely lead to mate. So in the face of all of these threats, the best try for black is king to e7. Now, after king e7, notice that you don't go knight g6 check. This is kind of an easy false path because it's like you have a discovery right here. If the knight is captured, you take the queen, but king to d8 and you've totally wrecked your coordination. And again, you're down a rook and you're losing this game. So after king e7, you got to keep the attack going. Queen captures on f7 with check. Here, black has two ways to move the king, and you avoid king to d6, naturally, walking into checks after castles. Yes, black can capture the knight on e5, but this is a successful king hunt. There are multiple ways to finish. This is a forcing path, but I like rook d4, the quiet move. And the quiet move here just threatens queen takes g7 and an immediate mate with queen f4, and it's mate in 3 according to the chess engine. So after queen captures on f7, the king falls back to d8. And now we have queen captures on g7, a pretty natural move that attacks the rook and defends the knight right here. So the best resource for black in this position is queen to b6. And now things get pretty tricky, especially if you're a greedy player. Black is threatening queen g1, queen f2, queen e3. All of these checks on the dark squares are huge problems for white. And these are such a significant problem that the most natural move in the world doesn't work. Queen captures on h8 with check. There are so many ways to go wrong by being just a little bit greedy in this particular problem. Here, after king c7, it looks like, you know, material is equal, but white should be winning, right? The knight is nice, the bishop is nice, black's king is on the run, these pieces can't get out. But black has enough counterplay with the queen and the knight, and black is actually equal. For example, castles, queen e3 check, the critical check, and after the king moves, the knight comes back into play, harassing the rook. And for example, rook d4, knight e4. Amazingly, black has enough counterplay, and white is not winning the game. We need to find a path to prevent the counterplay. So backing up, in this position, after queen b6, we don't capture this rook. We leave it hanging and we castle, making our king safer and developing the rook. Now with queen e3 check. In this position, we don't have enough. For example, king c2, and a big difference is that white is threatening rook takes d7, leading to mate. That changes everything, and black doesn't have time to get this rook, or to get this knight out of here. And all of white's threats, rook takes d7, queen takes h8, even rook takes h1, persist in this position. And if king c7, here, again, you don't have this because of the counterplay, but you have rook takes d7. And bishop takes d7, and queen takes d7, and it's actually mate in three more moves. King back to b8, queen d6 check. Let's pull the king back here. Oh, this one's nice. King a7, you have knight c6, pawn takes queen c7 checkmate. So back up here, if the king tries to go back to c8 instead, here you have bishop takes e6 and checkmate. Very pretty stuff. So this rook takes d7 threat is just very important, and that's why we don't capture the rook on h8. We need to keep that threat in the position. So after castles, the computer tries king c7 here, and now with the queen on b6, it's a critical defender, so rook takes d7 is not working. And if we take on h8, we allow this counterplay again, and black is able to hold a draw. Therefore, the only correct move is the very computery rook to d4. And this move just seals in the queen here. It keeps the attack on the rook on h8, keeps the idea potentially of rook takes d7, and it creates a big threat of pawn to a5, which is just burying the queen. For example, in this position after rook d4, if rook d8, you save the rook, you have a5, you bury the queen, and then you play knight f7. And the idea here of queen to e5 check is just devastating. So after rook d4, it's basically all over. The puzzle has essentially come to an end. Finally, the conclusion here is king b8, and we finish by finally capturing the rook. So that's an incredibly difficult puzzle right there. I hope you can understand why it is one of the most difficult problems on the site, carrying the highest possible rating at the moment. Maybe someday there will be a more highly rated problem, but 3,953. We've had two examples of very difficult puzzles, one ELO point shy of being the hardest puzzle on site, but being kind of a simple mate in four with some very subtle tricks in it. And this one just being an absolute beast with so many tempting false paths that would trip up the very best grandmasters in the world. Hope you've enjoyed this video. If you want to see more videos from chess.com, then of course subscribe and click on the video that is popping up on your screen as I speak.